Good evening. Spring is here. I'm so happy about it. Yay! How's everybody doing tonight out there? We have two very special guests, and this gentleman here, my goodness, Mr. Williams, Mr. Artis Williams, is that how you pronounce your name?
William Artis, that's it.
You have been on here once before, many years ago.
Yes.
So you are a very special guest also. And Matilda.
Hey, Nancy.
How are you?
I'm delighted.
You are the dream lady.
That's
so
right.
So later on, if anyone out there would like to call and ask about a dream they had,
mm-hmm.
and maybe Mr. Williams might have a dream too that he had last night. But
really?
I don't know if you want to share it.
No. Probably not.
Probably not.
So you haven't been here in a long time, but before I go further, I want to thank everybody who wished me happy birthday and who showed up at the party. And for those who didn't, they all wished me happy birthday and I thank them. And a special announcement, Saturday, May 11, April showers, bring May flowers.
Yes.
That's what Matilda says.
It's
and
true.
I agree. So there's going to be a get together on April, not April, I'm still thinking April. May 11, actually. It's on a Saturday, and it starts at 10, and it's in Brooklyn. So it's local, ladies and gentlemen. You can come by and have a great time. It's a meet and greet. It's also a networking party, and we're going to have music, and we're going to get together in a local area. So it will be fun. You won't have to travel too far the day before Mother's Day.
Mm-hmm.
So all the mothers and fathers out there, because there are men out there who do both jobs.
Mm-hmm.
And women too, mm-hmm. mother and father. So everybody out there can celebrate Mother's Day because, you know, Matilda and Mr. Williams, fathers take care of their children.
They do.
And their mother, both and father. So come celebrate that day.
Nancy, do you have an address where that party's going?
I do have an address, of course. But we're going to say they can check it out on the website at goddessbbw.com.
Oh, okay.
But they can also call the numbers, but I will give it out. Is it in Brooklyn? And it's at 274 4th Avenue in Brooklyn. And the name of it is Colony, I think.
Colony,
I believe.
Colony
274.
Okay.
Actually, that's the whole name, Colony 274. And the address is 274 4th mm-hmm. Avenue. And that is going to be the day before Mother's Day.
Mm-hmm.
So come down, get together, say hello to everybody.
And thank you to Robert Koff. He said happy late and happy birthday.
Oh, thank you, Robert. Thank you very much. Well.
And there's a number they can call,
Nancy. And there is a number that they can call. It's on the screen if you'd like to know more, if you forget the address, if you're not on the internet. And think about Mother's Day. All the mothers out there, that doesn't mean they're just women. Again, I'll repeat it. There are dads out there that do both jobs and women that do the father's job if they're not around. So I think that we all should come and celebrate that
mm-hmm.
yes.
on May 11th.
Yes.
Sure.
And did you give the time?
And oh, at 10 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
But you can have dinner. The kitchen is open to 1 a.m. That's the great part.
Okay.
So we will have some food. So if you'd like to even come earlier at 9-ish, but you can have dinner or something to eat until 1 a.m. in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll repeat that later on. So you know why I brought this, to cool him off in case, because he's in the middle over here. Just in case, you're going to cool him off later on.
I might need some more heat.
Oh, meaning getting closer to you, Artis? So tell me about you. I know that you've been around the FA world, which means fat admirer. There's a lot of people out there that don't come from way back from the parties, from Cafe 44 and the holiday happening, NAFA. By the way, NAFA, look that up, NAAFA. They're having a big party in June. So those of you who don't know about it, please look it up. It's going to be great. It's going to be in Las Vegas. And it's something not to miss. It's very special. So look up NAAFA if you can go on the computer in June. It's just wonderful. Mm-hmm. And that is Bill Fabre, who is the founder of NAAFA. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure you met Bill Fabre.
Yes, early on.
Many years ago,
yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's how I met you at one of the big, beautiful women parties. And we've been in contact on and off. And the last time you were here, we were talking about someone very special to you.
Yes.
And he's still playing music?
My son, Olu by name, he plays, but he is not doing only music. He also designs TV. Computerized videos,
mm-hmm.
and he has done that for some other people as well as
himself. Oh, that's very nice.
And his big hit now is the Funky Alphabet song.
Funky Alphabet song?
Yes.
Oh, I want to see, where can I see that?
Just plug in the Funky Alphabet song and it'll come up on YouTube. And it's teaching kids the alphabets, but not the old way that you hear it. And he references something to go with every alphabet.
That is,
A is
so
for Apple,
amazing.
For example.
Oh, wonderful.
And he has about 30 million.
Yours?
And
he is doing great on that. I mean, when my grandson was growing up, I was teaching him the ABCs. With there was a little red dog on there, and every time he says, Grandma, play it, ABC, and it was a song, and he would be dancing. So now this is new. I have to listen to this.
And so he did the music and all the visuals in it.
Oh, that's wonderful! Wow.
Mm-hmm.
So later on, I'm gonna have to go home and look at this on YouTube. And again, the name of
the funky alphabet song.
The Funky Alphabet song.
Wonderful.
Mm-hmm. Wow. And he created it.
Yes,
and
everything, and did all of the computerized versions of the visuals that go with it, and did the singing.
Oh, that is beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Did he study this? Did he go to art school?
He went to the New York City School of Arts for high school.
Oh, no wonder.
And he also went to Manhattan School of Music on Saturdays on our dime. So he has a background in music.
That's great. That is wonderful. Mm-hmm. Very talented.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And
very
he taught himself computerized stuff.
He
self-taught.
He's self-taught. Wow.
That's great. That's
how
the
old
best
is
thing.
He?
He's about about 44, I think.
Well, he's still a young man,
mm-hmm.
for sure.
Right.
I can't wait to look at this video. I wish I had it here to
play
it right now.
Me too.
I knew.
That would have been.
We never discussed that.
No.
I never brought it up.
When he was on your show, he was playing from an album that he had out at that time that had reached, I think, number 64 on Billboard at one point. So he was playing from that when he was on your show.
That was great.
Yeah.
That was quite a few years
yes.
ago.
Mm-hmm.
Quite a few.
So he also created a video. So he wrote the lyrics, the music, the words. He drew the characters.
Does he go under his name, or is he under a different name?
No, he's under Olu, O-L-U.
O-L-U?
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
No, so he's extremely creative, came up with the idea. He draws it, he wrote the song, the lyrics, the words,
mm-hmm.
and then he created a video.
That is so wonderful.
Mm-hmm.
I wish I had that to show some of the viewers for their children who have children. But at least that'll be something good that some of the viewers that are watching,
mm-hmm.
they can look that up right
now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So if
we
and
the
children
the
like it. We were invited to an Easter dinner by friends of our family, and we were around the table talking, and they mentioned something about Sadie's video,
right.
and we didn't know what they were talking about, and she said, sing it for him, Sadie. So she started singing, and my son went with me to that dinner at their home. He said, That's my video.
Really?
They didn't know it.
The children love that, though. Yeah, they love songs. That's right. How my grandson learned the whole alphabets and all of that. And he was running, and I had this little CD, and he would run in and look for it. The Red Dog, it was on a Red Dog tape. And he was like, what's that tape? And he played and singing. He was only like 2 years old.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's very educational for children. Mm-hmm. That is wonderful. Yeah. Well, congratulations to your son. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Thank you.
Next time I'd love for us to show it on here.
Yes.
But now the viewers again, they can see it on YouTube.
Right.
Great, mm-hmm. That is wonderful.
Say hello, Vanessa Edwards.
Say hello Vanessa.
Edward. How are you?
Vanessa Edwards.
Oh, Vanessa Edwards. Hi. Oh, Vanessa, how you doing? I know you can't talk back, but hello.
She said hello in the message on Facebook.
And we are going to have a party May 11th in Brooklyn.
Paul Vincent, he's watching.
Oh, so that's great.
Paul Vincent is watching.
Oh, hi, Paul. Hi, Paul. How you doing? I hope that you can come on the show next time and sing a tune for us.
Adrian Starr is watching also.
Oh, Adrian. Adrian, you are a sweetheart. We wanted to get you out here tonight, but we'll get you next time. She's Adrian Starr. She's going to be coming back to New York City soon.
Good.
Now, does she have any role in for us, Joey? Adrian, do you have anything that you can roll in?
Not yet,
but Adrian Starr is also known as Wild Diva. Some of the people out there know her, and she does some wonderful things. And she actually was in a Netflix series 5. She said she had a small part. She did a few other things, too.
Mm-hmm. And she models bubblegum.
Oh, yeah, lots of interesting things.
Okay.
Lots of interesting things. But when she calls in, she can explain it. And you are the dream person.
Oh,
and
the
more.
Dream weaver.
The dream weaver.
So, yes. So you don't want to share your dream? Not tonight?
Actually, I kicked myself. And it's embarrassing. Because in the dreams, formerly, I couldn't. I'd freeze in my dream. I could never fight back.
Oh.
But as I got older, I could, in my dream, I would actually fight back, kicking my wife and things like that. I had to,
That was real? In your dream, you would just kick because you were moving around?
Because I was defending myself in a situation in the dream. And so last night, I actually kicked my own self in the leg. So
really?
It was a little embarrassing.
Okay.
But you were kicking yourself.
But as soon as you wake up, you realize there wasn't that person I was fighting. It was me that I kicked.
Wow, so that's amazing.
I don't know why I was never able to do anything in my dream as I was growing up. If I were falling, I couldn't stop.
You couldn't stop it.
Mm. Right.
That's so interesting.
So artist acts out the dream.
He acts out his dreams.
Yes, because it appears to be so real.
It's real.
It's extremely real.
So
to the point that
he's
fighting.
Usually,
or are you dancing in bed?
No. Usually it's a situation that I'm not in real life,
mm-hmm.
but it calls for me to physically defend myself.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's something right. else. But mm-hmm.
And
you
as
are
a youngster, I wouldn't have been I wouldn't have moved. I would just be frozen. As I got older, I got freer, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
But when you were younger and you were a journalist, you were a journalist, but I'm sure you could still do it if you wanted to. And you were a very good journalist.
Yeah. Well, a writer never actually
stops writing.
Even when you're not writing, you really are. I was mentioning on the train from New Mexico, I was watching the countryside pass by, and then a children's story started unfolding.
Wow.
And I was thinking it straight through. I didn't write it, I just wrote the title of it. But you're writing when you're not writing.
That's
true.
Exactly. Do you find that when let's say the story was developing in your mind, let's say that at that moment you didn't put it down on paper, later on, are you able to recollect it? Are you able to retrieve it?
Yeah, sometimes it's something you have to do right then and there.
Yes, yes.
But at other times, with this one, I went through practically the whole thing in my head.
Wow.
So it's still there.
It's still there.
Recent, yeah.
It's recent.
Mm-hmm. But it's a good idea to write. And I have these little things you can talk into.
Oh, wonderful.
But I didn't use it for that.
I like that. I always wanted to write a book. And I went out and bought one from many years ago before the computers came in. It was in Radio Shack that doesn't exist no more. And you just press the button and you record.
Mm-hmm.
And I said I was going to write a book, and I never did. But it's all in here. But mm-hmm. if I don't take it out of here, it's not going to get out there.
Mm-hmm. All right, so get yourself the little recorder now.
I have one.
Oh, you did?
Okay. And I never used it. I just kept it and bought it, and it must be like 25 years sitting there.
I have a question. Maybe Joey can put the app, and you can record right on your phone.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
It's funny, because those little, from back in the days, those little cassettes they used to sell, that doesn't exist anymore. And
no.
I still have it home from when I was going to write a book.
Oh.
And you know how many books I have at home empty to write journals? I never did that either. Mm. It's all up here. It's and if it's it hasn't been written, but it should be.
Mm-hmm.
And make a play out of it too. Be interesting. We'll have to get Mr. Williams in that play.
So,
the dreamer. And Joey.
Well, these are the thoughts. These are memories.
No, yeah, I have wonderful memories of goddesses and the whole size movement, size acceptance. I mean, I have so much love and passion for big, beautiful people and admirers. And when I say and admirers, that means regular size people too, because back in the day, you remember back in the day when, I don't know if you remember, you would never see a thin person come in. I'm talking about a woman.
Right.
We're talking about 1968.
Mm-hmm.
When, how many years ago did you come to the party?
I think I started in the end of the 70s.
Okay. So back in the day, to what I remember when I used to go, it was always big women and all size men.
Mm-hmm.
I've never really saw a thin woman walk in the door unless she was a teacher or something.
Mm-hmm.
And then now, then that, and that was for years and years and years and years, because size acceptance, you know, so I said size acceptance should be everybody, but large size people always had the problem.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why it was created, to protect us.
Mm-hmm.
And NAFA is, you know, political. They've done a lot of great political things.
Yes.
And Bill Fabry is the founder.
Mm-hmm.
And I applaud him. And there's a lot of good people out there, like Conrad Blickensofer, who had magazines. He's another person. A lot of great people out there. And also, you know how many people in NAFA that kept it together? Did you remember? Do you remember the names, or you just?
I only remember Bill, because after a while, so many things are going through.
Right, but he was the founder, and then there were many other people, and the holiday happening was the best. I wish I could bring that back.
Mm-hmm.
So now there's a big event celebrating, and Bill Fabry is going to be there. That's an honor to have him there.
Mm-hmm.
So I can't wait, you know,
so
to see him.
So when you write your book, you make sure you're included.
Oh, he's wonderful. Oh, but he has, I'm going to mention that he has ample stuff. And he created that book, and everything in there is to help plus-size people,
mm-hmm.
which is great.
Mm-hmm.
Because back in the day, you couldn't find anything. You couldn't find a scale if you were over a certain weight.
Sure.
Right.
So he has things like that. And my favorite, you're going to laugh, I don't have it with me today, but I always carry it, a tape measurement, which is 95 inches, something like that. And I go to stores with it, because when they want to measure me or something, I go, what are you doing with that little thing? Here's mine.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I would always get like a case of measuring tapes. And it might be over 95 if I don't remember. But even when I go to a doctor, they're like, let's see your waistline. You know, like certain doctors, nutritionists, they just want to see, you know, how much, how big you are. I don't know, some people do that. When I go to get fitted, they want to measure you with a small tape. How is that going to happen? So I bring my own.
Mm-hmm.
And where did I get it from? Ample Stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And they're still online.
Mm-hmm.
And I thanked Bill Fabry. You can look that up.
Mm-hmm.
And remember back in the day, you couldn't find how to wash your back. You couldn't reach. All those things. Now they have them. But he still has everything for plus-size people to help them. And that's a good thing he's doing.
The idea was that you always had somebody to look down on if they were heavy.
Right, that is, that's right.
You always had somebody to look down on, and you could then raise yourself up in comparison, even though there was nothing particularly wrong with the person. But that kind of an attitude, so that it was so pervasive that even stores that cater to large-sized women, often if you went in, the models didn't look like the people.
No, the models were all thin.
Right.
But now, models are every size now. So now I don't discriminate. That's why I say size acceptance, because I know how it feels, and everyone who is large size knows how it feels. Some of the younger girls, they didn't have to suffer that part, and some of them do because of what everything was done for them already. But there are still people out there, and men and women, who are embarrassed to go outside because people are still making fun. So you have to teach your children. I taught my grandson when he was 4 years old, he saw my iPad. Imagine that. And he goes, "Look, Grandma, she's fat." And I looked at him, and his name is Michael, and I said, "Michael, Grandma's fat." He said, "No, Grandma, you're not." I said, "Take another look. Grandma's fat, and fat is not a bad word. She's just a full-figured woman. She's plus size, and, you know, people are not all the same."
Right.
After that, he never called another woman fat, because I taught him when he was a very young age.
Right.
Not, you know, because he never saw a bigger person except me, because he was young.
Right.
He was little, 2-3 years old. By the time he was 4, he already knew. You know, not to say, "Oh, look at that fat person," because he never knew. He never saw a fat person.
Right.
That's what happens.
But it's interesting
when they're tiny, when they're small.
He didn't see you as heavy.
Yeah, no.
But that's
and
love.
I was bigger than I was
when
now.
When you have love
that's
in
really
your heart.
Weird.
Right.
No, but it's he was loving you.
Yes, in a minute.
So the love he felt for you, he overlooked
exactly.
The fact.
Right. So this is what I'm saying about children. So people need to teach their children at a young age, you know, about size. Everyone should be treated equal. So I taught him that at a young age.
Yes.
So he no longer does that. So we have Adrian out there who's been waiting. Adrian Starr, we love you so much, and we've been waiting for you. And I know you are such a beautiful woman. And next time we will have you on.
Look, here's her picture.
Oh, there she is.
Look at her. Oh, my God. She is still beautiful as ever. And she is, she's out there. And is she going to be calling in now?
Yes, I'm waiting for her to call.
So we're waiting for Adrian Starr.
Okay.
She's great. She's sweet. She's living outside of New York, but she'll be back. And we'll do some fashion shows. And she's doing a lot of things.
She does. She looks
beautiful. And you've been in the size acceptance groups for many years. Wow.
Yes.
In the 70s.
Yes.
Those were the best times.
That may be her.
Adrian, she's so beautiful. Hi out there, Facebook, everybody. Hi, Adrian.
Hi, how are you?
We're good. You're so beautiful. That's a gorgeous picture of you.
Oh, thank you. That was just a few minutes ago.
Really?
Yes.
How are you?
I'm good. I mean, we really want to like take you from the screen and have you perform here. So what have you been doing, Adrian?
I would love to be back soon. I'm not in New York right now. I'm actually in Indiana. So
in Vienna?
Yes.
Yeah, it's been kind of crazy. Lots of moves.
Indiana, I know. You were in New York for quite a while.
7 years.
But when do you think you might be coming back? Not sure yet?
Hopefully soon. I'm looking at this summer.
Oh, great. Can't wait to see you. We'll talk on the phone, of course. So tell me some things that you're doing with yourself now, because I know before you were doing a lot of modeling at Goddesses and a lot of other things. You used to model for Goddesses, and when you come back, I'm sure we're going to do that again.
That was a lot of fun. I loved doing the lingerie shows and the fashion shows. It was a lot of fun. I do some online modeling still. I do YouTube. I have a YouTube channel.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
I know.
And I've done a lot, like a bunch of background acting.
Well, what are some of the films you've been in?
The main one that I've done, well, they're not films, they're shows.
Okay,
on
show,
Netflix.
Series. Right.
Orange is the New Black is the main one.
Okay.
And I was just a prisoner. I didn't have a name.
And what series was that?
Orange is the New Black.
I'm sorry?
Orange is the New Black. Was it series 5?
Episode.
Yeah, it was
episode
season
5.
I was a little bit on season 4 and then also on season 5, yeah.
That is great.
Yeah, and I've done some other shows, Younger.
And
several, but mostly just background. You know, you see me for a quick second, and then that's it.
So now we have Matilda here.
Hi,
and we also have Mr. Williams here.
Hello.
So if you have any questions for them, do you have any questions, artists, for Adrian Starr?
Yes. In the appearances that you made, were they part of a crowd or you individually?
Yeah, it was part of a crowd.
Mm-hmm.
Hello?
Yes. Adrian, I have a
question.
Yes. You've been modeling. Can you share?
Have I been modeling?
Uh-huh.
I'm having trouble hearing a little bit.
Would you like to share what kind of modeling you're doing?
Sure. I mean, I've done a lot of different kind of modeling. Obviously, I'm plus size, so plus size modeling. I've modeled for up-and-coming plus size clothing designers when I was in New York. I've done, you know, more adult-type web modeling.
Okay.
And so you're also on YouTube, you were telling me, Adrian Starr.
Yes, that's my new passion.
And so we have so many people that would love to see another big fashion show here, which we will have again. I'm wondering if you would be down here for Mother's Day. Where are you going to be May 11th? Because we have a big party on May 11th.
Oh, yeah? Where's that at?
This time we're going to do it local and very quaint and nice, so we can have a little get-together. We're not doing it too far because it's the day before Mother's Day. And it's going to be nice.
Yeah, that sounds great. I mean, I'll definitely try to get there.
Well, we'll
talk
about it. We'll talk on the phone about it. And I'm sure it's going to be lots of fun.
Give us the address.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Right. Well, it's going to be in Brooklyn. And it's 274 4th Avenue in Brooklyn. And it's going to be on the website. And if anybody doesn't know, they can always call. But, Adrian, you're doing really good. You look great, by the way. You've... still look young as ever. You have good genes.
Thank you. You look great yourself.
Oh, my goodness. I'm not telling your age, but, and I'm not telling mine.
No, we can keep that.